In this video, we will give you a step-by-step guide to one of the many possible walking routes on Ilkley Moor. This circular route is around 5 miles long and covers landmarks such as the Cow and Calf and the 12 Apostles Stone Circle. I have broken the video down into steps which you can navigate using the timestamps in the description below. I have also added a written summary of each step if you would like to refer back to any part of the route without re-watching the video, and linked to a website with an OS map plotting a very similar route to the one we are showing you here. Start your walk at Ilkley Moor Car Park. On your right will be the famous Cow and Calf rock formation. If you were wondering why it's called the Cow and Calf, it's because there's one large outcrop with one smaller boulder sitting on the floor close by, kind of like a cow and calf. You can take a look around the quarry next to the Cow and Calf before following the path up onto the moors. Now you want to head west, keeping the Cow and Calf on your right-hand side. You will soon pass more disused quarries on the left before dropping down into a small peaceful wooded area. Follow the path through the woods. On the other side of the trees, continue west following the path down the hill until you reach the rocky waters of Backstone Beck. You will see a small footbridge over the Beck. For this particular route, you don't want to cross the bridge. We started going that way by mistake and had to turn around and come back again. Instead, keeping the Beck on your right, look to the left and you'll see a signpost for Stanza Stones. Follow this path up the hill. You'll pass a couple more posts on the way up so you know you're going the right way. While this is quite a steep and rocky way up, it is also a fairly short scrabble to the top. Follow the path south, keeping Backstone Beck on your right. As the footstep gradually veers away from the Beck, you'll eventually reach a fork. Rather than taking the right-hand path, which takes you back down towards the Beck, take the left and continue heading up the hill. Eventually, the path will veer right. Keep following the path up the hill, nothing too steep, it's a fairly gradual incline, until you meet a paved pathway. Sections of paving stones have been added to the moor to help reduce erosion of the landscape. Continuing up this path, you'll see the Lanshaw Lad on your right, which marks the boundary between Ilkley and Burley. Further along the pathway, you'll come across a circle of rocks on your left-hand side. This Bronze Age rock circle is known as the 12 Apostles, and you'll now be around 400 metres above sea level. After you've stopped to take a look at the 12 Apostles, continue on your way. Shortly, you'll see that the path will fork. You want to take the path to the left and head east. If you pass higher Lanshaw Dam on your left, then you'll know you're going the right way. The path will slope upwards and eventually you'll reach another fork. Follow the path left across Burley Moor, heading downwards, keeping lower Lanshaw Dam on your right. As you follow the path down the moors, this is my favourite part of the walk, not just because it's downhill, but because of those amazing views. Once you reach the point where Ebor Way intersects Millennium Way, take the left turn which will lead you in a northwest direction. Shortly after joining this path, you'll cross a small bubbling stream. Once you're on the other side, ignore the path to the right and follow the left-hand path up the hill instead. Just stay on this path, it'll continue leading you right back to your starting point. On the other side of the road from the car park is the Cow and Calf pub. This is a lovely place to stop after a walk, especially in winter, because they have open fireplaces and there's nothing like going for a long winter walk and then warming yourself back up by the fire with some food and a pint. Now there will be a few things that will be useful for you to know before you head to Ilkley. Firstly is how to get there. If you're driving, park at the Ilkley Moor Car Park on Hangingston Road for free. There's a second parking option for the moors at White Wells Car Park if you would like to try a different walking route. If you aren't driving, then don't worry, you can easily reach the town of Ilkley by public transport as Ilkley has its own train station. If you do arrive by train or bus, then you can walk around 30 minutes or so from the town up to the Cow and Calf Rocks to start your walk. Another thing to be aware of is that the moors can get very boggy, especially when it's been raining, so do make sure you wear a sturdy pair of walking boots. Unsurprisingly, the moors do also get very windy. In fact, we did try to record some audio when we first arrived. This is the audio with a wind muffler. Oh dear. Before quickly giving up. So bear in mind that it could be colder than you expect on the moors. While the moor is beautiful all year round, as you can see, it's covered in heather. So if you go for a walk around August time when the plants are in bloom, then the moors will be a beautiful purple colour, and I think that this is the best time of year for a walk. If you find this walking guide helpful, then we do have a playlist of other walks in Yorkshire that we will be building up over time, so I'll add a link to that playlist here. Thanks for watching.